The clip editor is split into four sections: the main navigation, the animated property list, the main view, which can either be used by the dope sheet or the curves view, and the playback navigation. With the main navigation, it is possible to add or remove clips from the current project or to change the current opened clip. The current selected frame is displayed at the right, and the cursors below can be used to switch between frames that have at least one key. Animation events can be added to the current clip by clicking on the Add Animation Event button. More information about animation events will follow in a separate lesson. The project and clip settings can be accessed by clicking on the Settings button. For more details regarding the project settings, please check out the UMotion manual. In the Clip tab, it is possible to rename the current clip and to change the current frame rate. Enable looping if the exported clip should be played in a loop. Please note that the loop setting only has influence on the exported animation and not on the playback inside UMotion. The animated properties list shows all properties of the configured rig, all properties of every bone and transform that can be edited, like the position, rotation or scale properties, are listed. When right-clicking on a property, a context menu is displayed. The context menu items will also be covered in the next lessons. The time ruler on top of the dope sheet and curves view displays the current frame cursor position with a green arrow. By clicking somewhere on the time ruler, the frame cursor will jump to the clicked frame. When clicking and holding the left mouse button, the frame cursor can be dragged. This is useful for previewing the current animation. The dope sheet displays all keys that have been created for properties. Each row in the dope sheet is related to the property in the same row in the animated properties list. Keys can be selected by clicking on them or by rectangular selection. Keys can be dragged and deleted. It is also possible to copy and paste keys. Copied keys are pasted at the current frame cursor position, or when using the context menu item Paste, they are pasted at the clicked frame. Paste overwrites existing keys. It is also possible to insert keys by using Ctrl and pressing the I key, or by clicking on Edit, Insert. Insert will move existing keys so that they aren't overwritten. When right-clicking, a context menu with lots of features is displayed. Please check out the manual for detailed information. By using the mouse wheel or the zoom slider at the top right, it is possible to zoom in and out in the dope sheet and in the curves view. When clicking and holding the mouse wheel, it is possible to drag the view. The scroll bars can be used for scrolling and for zooming. The curves view displays the curves of selected properties. Editing animation curves is covered in a separate lesson. The playback section is used to preview the current animation. The area that should be played is defined by the start and end fields and respectively by the white arrows in the time ruler. The playback speed can be manipulated by clicking and dragging the mouse over the appropriate input field. Looping can be enabled and disabled by the toggle button. It's important to note that playback settings have no influence on the exported animation. The playback navigation buttons can be used to jump to the start and end of the playback area or to go to the next or previous frame. When moving the frame cursor and there are modifications on the current pose, a dialog window will automatically appear. It offers the possibility to keep the modifications for the new selected frame or to discard them. It is possible to permanently disable this dialog and always discard modifications when changing frames. Therefore, The appropriate checkbox in the UMotion preferences window needs to be checked.